टुडे प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार विल गिव लेक्चर एंड डिस्कशन ऑन द ग्रोथ ऑफ द फर्म, स्ट्रेटजी ऑफ ग्रोथ ऑफ द फर्म. दिस इज द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर एनी ऑफ द इंडस्ट्री दैट द हाउ द ग्रोथ कैन बी मेड. Growth emerges an inevitable necessity, especially under the contemporary economic condition. The results aimed by merger, acquisition, and joint venture are not merger, acquisition, and joint venture, but growth, staying power, and competitive advantage. This study introduces the basic suggestions for the enterprise to achieve business success and to acquire growth, staying power. And competitive advantage. It is underlined that in order to achieve these goals, the enterprise should analyze their corporate and financial structure and settle their strategy in line with the results of the analysis. The keywords are the strategic alliance, synergy, merger, acquisition, joint venture, franchising, and the outsourcing. In general, enterprise desire to carry on their economic activities, produce and market goods and services, and thus to grow and gain profit. Enterprise feel the need to grow in view of the factors such as economic and environmental conditions, developing technology, increase of the customer needs, and the competitive atmosphere. For the most part, the growth of an enterprise is deemed positive. However, an inappropriate growth makes it difficult to behave flexibly. While the enterprise that are active in the market grow normally, it becomes difficult to survive for the enterprise and cannot adapt to the new condition. With the impact of the globalization, continuous and enlargement of the business operation have become the most important goals of the enterprise. In order to achieve the said goals in the competitive atmosphere, enterprise will either utilize their own opportunity or benefit from external sources. With this aim, the enterprise can have recourse to merger, acquisition, or the strategic alliance. This study aims to examine the international growth strategy of the enterprises in all their dimensions. To this aim, drawing on the concept of the enterprise growth, firstly, the definition, types, skills, and causes of growth are explained. Secondly, the issue of the merger is discussed as an international growth strategy and the reason that lead company to merge the illustrated through the example from the merger of the big company. Thirdly, the various type of the causes of the purchasing another strategy of the international growth are explained. The last part of the study is devoted to the examination of the strategic alliances, their regions, joint venture process, and possible jeopardy that would be faced in this process. The definition and types and skills of the growth. The concept of the enterprise growth denotes the complex development during the phase an enterprise goes through from its establishment to the phase of the maturity. Growth is a process of change and development. It implies increases in certain components of the enterprise and regard to either volume or the amount. However, besides the increases in the volume or amount, the development of concerning quality should also be mentioned. The quality aspect of the growth involves the improvement of the quality of the material human component that constitute the enterprise structure. Enterprise growth can be divided into two, internal growth and the external growth. Internal growth can be achieved by means of the enlarging the existing operation. In general, enterprise enter the process of growth on the basis of their own resources. Methods such as self-financing, borrowing, or finding new capital can be used to meet the need of the financing in the internal growth process. An enterprise can enlarge its market operation or seek new markets by increasing its production capacity via the seed method. External growth, on the other hand, is the growth of the enterprise achieved by the utilizing the resources and efforts of the other enterprises. In other words, it can be defined as an enterprise embarking on the merger or joint venture with other enterprise with the aim of increasing its share in the existing market. And internal growth can take the form of the horizontal growth or the vertical growth, while an external growth can take the form of the horizontal growth, vertical growth, circular growth, or the mixed growth. The causes that lead enterprises to the external growth. Enterprise seek opportunity for developing the most viable strategy in order to maintain their competitive advantage and profitably operation, which are the two basic aims of the enterprise. In fact, all the causes that lead an enterprise to growth can be summarized as one aim. To increase the net present value of the enterprise, the major causes that lead enterprise to growth are as follows. The necessity of lowering the cost, the advantage provided by the tax law, integration of the production method, increased sales, risk reduction factor, elimination of the commercial boundary, privatization, existence of the high number of the firm that operate simultaneously, gaining competitive advantage, ease of the financing, unearthing of the unnoticed value, synergy effect, increasing profitability. The definition types and causes of the enterprise mergers. Enterprise merger is the merging of two or more companies with other to establish a new enterprise or joining of the one enterprise in the another enterprise. Enterprise merger is there. The primary aim of the enterprise is to gain maximum profit. As this aim is highly difficult to achieve in the perfect competition market, enterprise tend to eliminate some of the perfect competition condition in order to gain more profit. Imperfect competition markets such as the monopoly, duopoly, monopsony, oligopoly, and dyspony emerge as a result of the such tendency. One of the various methods that give rise to the imperfect competition market is the merging of the enterprise with each other. Merger becomes especially inevitable if the growth rate of the enterprise is smaller than that of the market. The agreement or mergers at the various levels, which range from the loosest relationship to the complete merging of the enterprise, can be classified into the six categories. Enterprise that sign gentleman agreement. Gentleman agreement is agreement based on the promising of the contracting party and which does not impose any sanction in case or more of the party renounce it. Gentleman's agreement can be made by the two or more enterprise to share the material resources and markets or to establish de facto monopoly by canceling price competition. Thereby, enterprises gain strength against the seller, buyers, or the competitors, for the aim is to gain economic benefit by changing the existing condition in favor of the party that participate in the agreement. Consortium, in order to become preferred bidder for the large scale contract, enterprise from the same or different country and from the same or different field of the expertise corporate, combining their financial resources and technological or other advantage. Constraints are established in order to achieve goals such as obtaining the adequate capital, spreading the risk, and etc. This corporation ends with the completion of the contract and the incoming profit is distributed among the enterprise within the framework of the agreement. The member enterprise of the consortium preserve their economic and legal independence. Cartels. Cartel is a monopolistic union established between more than one enterprise operating in the same field of the production with the aim of the canceling competition among the members of the cartel. The enterprise that unite in the form of the monopolistic union gain advantage in the market and hence increase their profits via canceling competing among themselves. In cartels, the capitals forming the unions are combined but used together for a specific purpose. To form a cartel, the participating enterprise should be strong and effective in the market and have the biggest share in the production of the good or in a specific field of the production. In this way, the cartel can gain advantage over the enterprise outside the cartel. Cartel are established in the form of the price cartel, sales cartel, or the quota cartel. Trust. trust is a form of the monopolization formed by the joining of the enterprise under one management. Although they are similar to the cartel, the economic and legal entity of the enterprise cease to exist and the enterprise are disincorporated in case of the trust. In this regard, trust symbolizes permanent union as opposed to the temporary union in the case of the cartels. Trust are the giant organization that keep down market and restrict free competition, and therefore they are banned in many countries. Holdings are the organization which take other companies under control by buying their shares. Holding consists of the one parent company and subsidiary company connected to the parent company. The parent company controls the management of the subsidiary company active in the same or different fields by buying their shares. Mathematically, 51% of the total share of the subsidiary company should be owned by the parent company. Holding is not a legal group. The parent company and the subsidiary company protect their legal independence, although they belong to the holding group. The basic aim of the holding is to gather the parent company and the subsidiary company under one management. Full-fledged merger. As the name implies, full-fledged merger is the merger of two or more enterprise to become one enterprise. Full-fledged merger can be achieved when an enterprise buys or joins another enterprise, or when two enterprise merge to become one new enterprise. Merger of the two company to become one big enterprise, or merge of the two company to become a joint company, are common in business life. There are many approaches concerning the reason of the merger. We share many common points. The said regions can be listed as follows. Advantage of the large scale operation. In parallel with the increase in the production, the reduction in the average production cost unit or expansion of the fixed expenses over a large production volume represents a general expectation. The large scale operation that become possible as a result of the merger enables the organization to use the existing machines and instrument in a some effective way, and to include the ineffective means of production in the production process. The said operation also justifies the use of the machine with high capacity and high efficiency in production, albeit they are expensive. Mergers are also facilitate technical information flow between the company and enables them to the carry out research and development project. The R&D project, which are not regarded to be economic in terms of the single form, becomes so in case of the merger and can be financed more easily. The power and the strength of the firm also increased by the merger, and it become easier for them to carry out marketing activity. The cost of the purchase become more profitable as the amount of the purchase increase as a result of the merger and expanding of the fixed cost over a large production. Volume creates the opportunity of the lowering cost. Combining the services that perform the same function, which provides a considerable degree of the labor saving, is another benefit to the larger scale operation that can be multiplied. In summary, it can be said that the company that perform larger scale operation as a result of the external growth gain competitive advantage over their competitors in the market in many aspects. Financial region. Fast growing enterprise may face difficulty in finding the necessary financial source for their growth. In such a case, it becomes reasonable to meet the financial requirement by the merger with enterprise with the high liquidity instead of slowing down growth. As merging company combine their financial affinity, it becomes possible for them to get higher amounts of the funds under more favorable condition. Merger is also performed by the company with surplus such cash and good investment opportunity for the use of their capital. Company that grow through the merger also gain benefits such as reduction in the credit cost, more profitable return by the region of the balanced production, and delay of the tax payment. Tax advantage. Benefiting from tax advantages is the another important factor that leads enterprise to the merger. The enterprise which have accumulated losses, but also the chance to make the related reduction on the future gain, can merge with a profitable enterprise. By this way, they can obtain the opportunity to get the rid of the paying taxation on the basis of the profits to be gained from merger within the frame of the tax law and the loss reduction. Advantage of reducing risk via the differentiation. For enterprise, differentiation through the external growth is considerably important with regard to the spreading risk, while entering a new product is deemed a risk for a small enterprise. Developing a new product by means of the merger helps the reducing the risk. Having a competent management. A good manager in is an invisible production factor. In order to benefit from such a manager completely, the scale of the enterprise should be a certain level. Enterprise that lack the competent management and the opportunity to employ good managers can seek solution to their management problems through merger. The said problems can be solved through the merging an enterprise with a good management. By this way, the enterprise can gain the opportunity to have experienced and knowledgeable managers in fields such as marketing, financing, and international operation. Market power. Market power can be defined as the power to fix and apply a price higher than the already existing price level in the competitive market. There are three sources of the market power: to prevent entrance to the market, product differentiation, and the market share. Considering these three sources, increasing market power through the external growth is one of the considerable importance as mentioned above. Psychological reason. Individual motivation such as the desire to put the oneself is good light in the fields of the management and financing. The ambition to manage a bigger organization, the will to guarantee the survival of the enterprise and the anxiety of the becoming old-fashioned may also influence the decision of the growth. Definition and type of the acquisition. Indeed, acquisition is another form of the merger. Acquisition is the purchase of the one enterprise or most of its share by another, in which the purchased enterprise becomes connected to the purchasing enterprise and controlled by it. In order to enter a new market or to increase efficiency in the existing market, an enterprise includes another enterprise which cannot operate satisfactorily in its body. The difference between the acquisition and merger is that in acquisition, all the assets of the purchased enterprise, including the debits and the receivable, are added to the assets of the purchasing enterprise. In this strategy of the merger, the purchased enterprise adopts the identity of the purchasing company. In terms of both the purchasing and the purchased enterprise, the aim that lead enterprise to the external growth via the strategy of the acquisition can be listed as follows. Increasing the stock price and stock value in the market via cultivating an image of the strong enterprise in the market and adding to profit per stock with the new opportunity gained. Increasing the growth rate of the enterprise more than that of the existing internal growth strategy. Balancing or perfecting the product line. Reducing the number of the competitor. Differentiating product line when the life curve of the existing product reaches maturity. Obtaining the necessary resource more quickly. Increasing the existing potential returns via deducting the past losses of the enterprise from the fulfillment. Increasing the efficiency and profitability resulting from the synergy to be formed between the purchasing and the purchased company via with regard to the production, marketing, channels of the distribution, technology, general expenses, research and development, etc. For the purchasing company, increasing the stocks of the owners and the value of the enterprise, organizing and streamlining the activity by means of the sources to be obtained. Increasing the growth rate of the enterprise by means of the sources to be obtained from the purchasing enterprise. Increasing the market value of the enterprise, hence the stock price. Contributing to the development of the strong strategy for differentiation by joining the existing enterprise owned by the purchasing enterprise. Holding a place in top management of the purchasing company. Ensuring the survival and development of the enterprise in difficulty. Acquisition which seems great on paper may result in the disappointment for the many companies. There are cases where the purchasing company could not find the synergy they expect for the years or could not make people work together. There are also cases in which the special feature of the purchased company, its best employee or most valuable client, for instance, were lost in the impractical combination of the two companies. The success of acquisition is influenced by the many factors, such as the amount to be paid for acquisition, the management of the employee, culture, assets, and competition principle of the company. Definition and types of the strategic alliances. Strategic alliance are agreement between the two or more independent company which come together to cooperate in line with the specific strategic aim. Strategic alliance which increase in parallel to the increase in the global competition encourage the national company to enter into competition in the global scale and provide international company with competitive advantage by reason of the fact that there are many growth activity that company have resources to complement each other and that this kind of the alliance create synergy. A strategic alliance may be entered into the between the competitors in the same market, between the producer and clients, or between the 10 enterprise from the different markets. Strategic alliance can be grouped into three categories. Joint venture. In joint venture, the cooperation between the enterprise reaches the level of the ownership and shareholding in order to carry out a specific project or business activity in a specific field. Together, enterprise start a new enterprise with a new title and identity by combining their assets and skills. However, as opposed to the merger, the individual corporate identity and assets of the main enterprise also continue to exist. The main of the new initiative is to carry out jointly the specific project or business activity that the main enterprise would have difficulty or in would fail carrying out individually. After the completion of the project, the enterprise which was started with the aim of the carrying out the project can be completely liquidated as your task is finished. License agreement can be considered as one of the easy ways of entering an external market. By license agreement, licensor sells a production process, techniques, brand, and patents to a license for a consideration. With license agreement, the license or party produces its products in a foreign country. In other words, makes a foreign investment, but did not spend capital for this. Hence, does not run a risk. The licensed enterprise allowed to sell the products pays a certain share for each product to the license, or this share is called royalty. Franchising. Franchising is the assigning of the one enterprise of the selling of its product to the another enterprise by granting its agency for the authority of the effect sale. This kind of the corporation is the common strategy. In the franchising system, with an agreement, the enterprise owning or the patent right assign the right to the produce and sell a certain commodity or service to other enterprise with the different title, standards, and the commercial method. In this case, franchiser gives the guarantee to the contracting independent enterprise of being exclusive enterprise in a certain region. In consideration of this, the independent enterprise guarantee to pay to the franchiser the franchisee fee and usually a certain percentage on the sales proceeds determine its agreement. The assignment of a commodity or service is one of the most important differences between the franchising system and the agency or a dealer system. With the franchise agreement, a continuous business relationship is established between the contracting party. The best part of this system is that a person both wants an independent enterprise, but he is still alone. An entrepreneur who enters business life as the owner of the franchise also buys a proved and well-known brand, a certain image, and the experience of the franchise. Reasons for setting a strategic alliance. The aim that the lead enterprise or a strategic business into the setup of a strategic alliance can be listed as follows: acquiring new technology or production opportunity and the skills. Gaining the opportunity to enter easily to the specific market. Gaining the opportunity to share the financial resource needed for entering a new market. The consequent risk with the partner. Creating a competitive advantage or strengthening the existing one, bringing together the privileged competitive advantage of each other. alliance process and the way of the production from the hazards that would be encountered in this process. Strategic alliance are formed as a result of a specific process, starting out with the analysis of the enterprise is useful in terms of the clarifying the position of the enterprise on the way to form a strategic alliance. A enterprise evaluates the decision to form a strategic alliance via the seed analysis. A strategic decision consists of the three sub-phase: situational analysis, definition of the potential of the strategic alliance, and evaluation of the return of the potential for the partner. After deciding to form a strategic alliance, party should analyze issue of form such as the field of the cooperation, intensity of the cooperation, and the growth opportunity. The field of cooperation is determined on the basis of the direction of the cooperation and the related value of the chain activity. The intensity of the cooperation depends on the degree of the resource allocation and the formalization. This phase is the fine-tuning of the formalization of the cooperation. The determination of the term of the cooperation is of the crucial importance for the alliance. When cooperation is mentioned, it is often assumed that the partnership is formed by the two enterprises. However, more than two enterprises can join the strategic alliance. This phase may give rise to a network of the different company or enterprise units to which each party contributes to the general system with its own skills. Analysis of the growth opportunity should cover enterprise system and process, product and services, skills and issue related to the market. The next phase is the selection partner. The focus of this phase should be the basic harmonization, strategic harmonization and the cultural harmonization. Basic harmonization become possible when the activity and expertise of the two company complement each other so as to increase the return potential, while strategic harmonization is possible. And the aim of the two company are the in harmony. Cultural harmonization, on the other hand, requires the two company to be ready to accept the cultural differences of the each other. Although the strategic alliances actor offer several potential advantage to the partner, it is not always easy to realize them. It is important to select the right partner as well to be able to manage the process duly. The three steps that minimize the potential hazards are the to determine the aim that express in clear terms how the company will benefit from the cooperation, to define potential partner and evaluate the advantage and disadvantage of each, to reach an agreement concerning the critical success factor. Results and suggestion. Merger has become attractive for company on the basis of the fact that the company which worry about their survival in the face of the rapidly changing competitive condition, or which aim to grow stronger in the face of the fierce competition, plan to grow by the merger and even to have to stay in the market by showing themselves off on the international stage. Consequently, companies should grow by the choosing the appropriate size for an enterprise by using its existing size and capacity in the most efficient way, and by increasing the activity of the enterprise in consideration with changes in the external environment. By this way, it becomes possible for a company to become more profitable and survive. References are given here. We have dealt of the, in this lecture, strategy of growth of the firm, how the growth of the firm will be there, abstracted given there, introduction is explained there, then the definition and types of the growth is explained, causes and lead enterprise to the external growth is explained, definition and types of the causes of the enterprise merger is explained, enterprise signed gentleman agreement, constituent, cartels, trust, holdings, full-fledged merger, advantage of the large-scale operations, financial reasons, tax advantage, advantage of reducing risk via the differentiation, having a competent management, market power, psychological region, definition of type of the acquisition, definition and types of the strategic alliance, joint venture, license agreement, franchising, reasons for setting up the strategic alliance, result and suggestion are discussed here.